Carbonara is usually associated from and the Lazio region, but, as with many other Italian dishes, in Italy its origin provokes much speculation and debate. Some people associate it with pasta cacio e uova, Neapolitan dish tossed with malted lard, beaten raw eggs, and cheese, as documented in Ippolito Cavalcanti's in 1839 Neapolitan cookbook. Because the name comes from the word carbonaro, called Colberne, some believe the dish was created as a hearty, easy-to-make meal prepared by men working outdoors for long periods of time. Others trace it to the Allied liberation of Rome in 1944, with American GIs bringing their daily ration of eggs and bacon to local restaurants, adding them to their favorite Italian dishes. The first written reference to the dish supporting this story appeared in La Stampa newspaper in 1950. It described carbonara as a dish prized by American servicemen. Now let's make it. For this recipe, you will need 3 liters of water, 220 grams of spaghetti, 25 grams of guanciale, you can use pancetta or fat bacon instead, 50 grams of pecorino cheese, 2 whole eggs, 1 egg yolk, salt and pepper. First of all, boil and salt your water and cook your pasta till al dente. Time of cooking depends on what pasta you have, so just take a look at the package and make sure you do it right. Now cut your guanciale, pancetta or bacon into small strips. Add your meat to the pan and stir it till nice and brown. No need to use oil as meat is fatty. When your pasta is cooked, you can add it to your pan with additional half a cup of pasta water. Next, add 2 eggs and 1 egg yolk to bowl and grate about 45 grams of pecorino cheese. Now just mix it with fork. Add eggs and cheese mixture and mix it. Now, it's time to put it on your plate. Finish it with a little bit of pecorino cheese and some freshly grounded black pepper. Now, you can enjoy this beautiful Italian dish.